So what are the two development processes we discussed in the last class? Stage gate process and spiral design process, right? So when is stage gate process used? Anybody? Or when is spiral process used? Basically, when it's a time compressed industry where you need to bring out the product at a particular time, you cannot wait, or whatever may be the delay, you need to release the product. Such kind of companies normally use spiral design process. Okay. So most of the consumer products or most of the other products other than software normally go for a stage gate design process. So what is a stage gate process? As the name suggests, you have different stages, and at the end of each stage, there is a gate which will evaluate the progress in that particular stage, and if it satisfies the conditions for going to the next stage, it will pass the gate and then go to the next stage. And like that, it will continue multiple stages and gates. It will reach the final stage and the product will be released. That is basically the stage gate design process, right? So what is the main difference between stage gate process and spiral process? Yeah, in stage gate, you have a 100% complete product at the end of one stage gate process, right? And spiral process? Yeah, so spiral is basically a multiple stage gate process. So you'll have one stage gate process completed, you have a product, but it may not be 100% complete. Then it will go through one more stage gate process, and then you'll have another product which is still not complete. And like that, it will go multiple stage gate process, and finally you will be having a product at the end of two or three stage gate process. That is basically the spiral process. So we look at the stage gate process, and then I talked about some of the most important stages in product development. So we discussed about three important stages in any product development when you go for a stage gate process. We talked about three important stages. What are these stages? Understand the opportunity. Understand the opportunity. Develop a. Develop a vision, right? Or develop a concept. And third one, implement, right? So these are the three stages in any product development. You take any new product development or a product which you want to modify. For example, all of you are using cycles, right? How many of you are not using cycle? Okay, all of you are using cycle. Are you happy with the cycle? Yes or no? There are some no's also, right? So when you say yes, you don't see any opportunity to develop a new product, right? Because you are happy with the product. Unless somebody comes with a better product, you will be happy with this product. You are not going to design anything, or you are not going to think about a new product. So if you feel that this product is not good or this product can be improved, then you are actually seeing an opportunity to develop a new product. For example, you feel that your cycle, it is very difficult to pedal it in the morning. You are in a hurry and you have to pedal all the way. By the time you reach here, it will be sweating all the way, and you feel it is very uncomfortable. That may be one reason why you are not happy with the product. Or you feel that you have to put a lot of effort to do the pedaling. So somebody will think that, okay, why can't we make a new product or a new bicycle which you don't need to put this much of effort? Okay, that is the starting point for a new design. You may design or you may tell someone else to design, but that is the first stage where you try to identify an opportunity to design a product. That is the opportunity where you feel that, okay, there is a problem with the existing product, I have an opportunity to design a new product. But that alone is not sufficient to design a product, because many people would have thought the same thing before you. You are not the first person to use cycle, or you are not the first person to feel that there is a problem with the cycle, right? So there might be lot of other people who thought about it and then dropped it because of various reasons. So the understand the opportunity is basically looking at that opportunity and then see, is it really worth going ahead with that opportunity? Okay, because you may be unhappy with many products. Okay, you may be unhappy with the teacher, you may be unhappy with the classes, right? But you don't have much of an option, right? You need to come and then listen. But the point is, just because you are unhappy with the product, or just because you don't feel that the product is good, that does not mean that there is an opportunity always. So you have to do a lot of analysis to see whether there is a real opportunity or not. That is basically known as understand the opportunity. Okay, it's not only identifying an opportunity, but understand the opportunity based on various factors. That is the first part. And once that part is clear, you are actually going through a gate, and this gate will actually analyze, is there a real opportunity? And if it passes through this, then it will go to the develop a concept stage. So these are the three important stages. Oops. It's not really. Okay. So understand the opportunity, develop a concept, implement a concept. So all the activities needed to make the decision to launch a product. So there are multiple activities, and all these activities which are needed to make the decision to start a product design is basically the understand the opportunity, and all activities to make the decision to what the product should do and what the product will be doing is basically develop a concept. What happened? And implement a concept is basically you make the product, test it, and then prove it that everything is fine, and then release it in the market. So these are the three important stages in the design of a new product. Okay, so understand the opportunity, develop a concept, implement a concept. These are the three stages which you will be going through when you start designing a new product. And in this class, we will be focusing only these two aspects, because implementing a concept, you require a lot of other engineering inputs. So we will be talking about how to understand the real opportunity to design a product, and how do we develop a concept to design a product. That is basically the functional and conceptual aspect of the design. Okay, so let us look at the understand the opportunity and then see what are the different stages involved in that. Because as I told you, it is not just that you are unhappy with the product, is not an opportunity always, but maybe that may be one of the opportunities, one of the activities. So understand the opportunity can actually be divided into four important activities. That is, develop a vision for a new product. That is, you need to have a vision for a new product to come to the market. That is the first stage in understanding the opportunity. So what product do we wish were out there? That is where actually your own interest, or your own imagination, or your own understanding, you are not happy with the existing product, or you feel that there would have been a good product which will meet your requirement, right? So this is how actually your new products are coming out. When I say that I am not happy with this projector, or I feel that, okay, there can be a much better product than this, that is actually a starting of my vision for a new product. Similarly, when you feel that your specs is not good, so having a specs is not that convenient, right? Most of you are using specs. You know that it is not that easy to use a specs. You have a lot of difficulties, and sometimes you, if it is broken, you have a difficulty in reading, or you need to maintain it, or you need to change it every 2 or 3 years. So there are a lot of problems with the specs. So like this, when you have such things, you will see that, okay, oh, there should be a better product to handle these things. That is the first part what product do we wish were out there. In the second one, what is difficult with the current product we use? What is the difficulty? What are the difficulties that we face when we have a current product, and what are the difficulties we have, and why does it not do something we want it to do? What makes it not possible to do things which we want it to do? Again, taking the example of projector, I don't want to connect this and then look for the compatibility issues. So that is the problem that I am facing with this. And why is it not able to do that? Why can't it directly connect to a to the projector? Or can we have something else to do this? Okay, so these are the things which actually will lead to a vision for a new product. The answers to these questions, these and similar questions, are vision for a new product. So you are either not happy with the current products, or you feel that the current products are not able to do things which you want this to do, or there are some difficulty with the current product in executing what you are expecting. All these will lead you to think about a new product or vision for a new product. So that is the vision for a new product, or we call just the develop a vision. So we want to develop a vision for a new product. But all of us can have hundreds of visions, right? We can always think about a lot of things as a vision. I just want to fly from here to the hostel. It's a vision for me. I don't want to cycle, I don't want to walk, I don't want to run. If I start from here, I can just fly, okay, with my backpack. By pressing a button on my backpack, I'll be able to fly. That's a vision, right? You can have, like that, you can have hundreds of visions. But then, are these visions are a feasible one? Is there a real opportunity in developing that? Or is that a feasible thing? That is the second stage, which we call as the market opportunity analysis. So you have a vision for developing a new product. Okay, that is the vision. You feel that yes, the current products are not good, they are having a lot of difficulties in meeting our requirements or our expectations. So I want to develop a new product. Somebody says, I want to make an electric cycle. Simple. So you are not happy with your bicycle. So you want to say that, okay, I don't want to pedal every day from my hostel to here. So if it is an electric cycle, it would have been much better for me, so that I don't need to pedal. I just get into the cycle and press a button. It will just take me. So I'll just simply sit there like any other automobile. That's a vision. But then the next question is, okay, so if I develop this, is there someone going to buy this, or it will be only me who will be buying this or using this? And then there is no point in making it, right? Because whenever you develop a product, you have to sell the product in the market. And if you are not able to sell it, there's no point in making it also. So the second aspect of designing the product is to check, is there a market for the product, the market opportunity analysis. That includes whether the vision can be transformed into a successful realization. So in the case of a cycle, it is not that difficult to convert a normal bicycle to an electric bicycle. Many people have tried. So it can be transformed into a successful realization. There's not much of difficulty. But then if you have a vision that I want to fly, I don't want to use a cycle, I don't want to use any other thing, I just want to fly from here, it's not that easy realization. So you need to check whether your vision can be realized or can be transformed into a product through some realistic means. So is there a realistic way to transform your vision to reality or to a product? That is the first question we need to answer. And whether the product can be developed and implemented into a product at a worthwhile profit. So any development, any design, or any product coming into the market, the ultimate aim of the designer or the person who actually develops is to make profits. Because it's not for a charity, not a charity work. Any business or any entrepreneurial activity should lead to profit. So the market opportunity will look at this, where is there a way we can get a profit in this business. That is the ultimate goal of market opportunity analysis. So do you do a lot of surveys, market surveys, cost analysis, development cost, etc., etc., and finally check, can this be developed with the, or can we get profit out of this business? When you feel that there is a good market for the products, there are a lot of people ready to buy this, and the cost of production or cost of the product will be reasonable and can be it's an affordable one, then only you will get profits. Okay, therefore you need to make sure that there is a profit possible in that one. You know, that actually depends on the type of investment you make, but normally consumer products will be within 2 years you should be able to make profits. But then medical devices and all, sometimes it will take 5-6 years. Okay, so depending on the product and the level of investment you make, that is it may vary from 2 years to 5 years, 6 years. Of course you don't get profit immediately, but the question is that, is there a way, I mean, you see that the product can actually be marketed with their ultimate profit at the end of 1 or 2 years, depending on the product. But this will be actually understood when we do a market analysis, and then we prepare a project plan. It says that, okay, first year you have to invest this much money, and you will be having only very less income in the first year. Second year investment may come down, but your revenue may go up, and at the end of 2 or 3 years you will start seeing that you are getting money coming to the so that is the way how you do the analysis. So that is the second one in understanding the opportunity. First you need to have a vision, the second you need to look at the market and then see whether it can be sold in the market with a reasonable profit. The second one, okay, now you did this analysis and then you found that, okay, your vision is very great and your market opportunity says it is good and there is a good profit that you can make. So we'll be having a, so this is stage, and then you will be having a gate here, then you analyze and then you come to the this stage, and then again you will be having a gate here. And what the market opportunity also tells, that it's a good opportunity, there is a good profit possible, then we take you to the next stage, that is the customer need analysis. And this seems to be the most challenging task, because so far you talked about your own vision only. Okay, you had a vision, that so you thought that, okay, it's a good product and you wanted to design it, and then you looked at the market, looking at from the commercial point of view only. Okay, what is the commercial aspect of it, how much money you can make. And now the question is, once you decided to develop the product, it is not that you are going to use, or you are not the only person going to use, actually it will be used by a large number of people. So you need to know what they are looking in the product, that is the most important, because you need to provide what the customer is asking in the product or customer is expecting in the product. So that is where we need to do a detailed customer need analysis to know what the customer population is expecting in that product. And this will be the most interesting part, because whatever you thought about this product, when you go and ask the people, they will say, oh, this is not what I want, I want something else, or I am expecting this in this product, I don't want I'm not looking for only a electric cycle. You thought that electric cycle will be the great thing, but then people said, no, I'm not looking for electric cycle, I'm looking for something else, I don't want this to be a two-wheeled one because balancing is an issue. Or my problem is not about the electric pedaling, my problem is with respect to the tire getting punctured, or the maintenance I need to make, or the theft of my cycle. These are my problems, why are you worried about electric cycle? So like this, you will see that there are hundreds of needs for the customer which you thought is not at all important. So this is where you will get lot of insight on the product, saying that what you need to provide in the product may be completely different from what you thought of providing in the product. And the important aspect is that if you are not able to provide this in the product, customer is not going to buy the product. So understanding the customer is one of the most important and sometimes most difficult part of product development in the first stage itself. That is, we are in the understanding the opportunity. Because when the customer says something and you are not able to provide, then there is no opportunity to develop a product. Your opportunity is lost. So what the customer population wants the new product to do is very important in understanding the opportunity. And there are different ways to do this. There will be a dot of methods which we'll be going through in detail later. What are the different ways in which you can develop the product? So his question was, can we have the customer need analysis first and then put it under the vision? That was your point, right? Yeah. See, this one is, first you try to start a product. I mean, you have need to have a vision for a new product. Then only you can go to customer and ask whether you like this or not, or you want this or not. If you simply go to customer, you don't know what to ask the customer, because you don't know what product you are going to make unless you have a vision for a new product. That's why you need to have a vision for a new product. You should have an idea. Yes, I think according to my own understanding, this may be the right product for the people, people may be looking for. And then only I can go and find out from the customer what they are looking in that product. Okay. So if you are saying that, okay, I can go to customer and then ask what they are looking for, then it is not for the need analysis of the thing. It is more of what kind of products they want in the markets. Okay. So we are not looking or asking about what kind of products you want in the market. We are trying to find out, yes, I'm going to make an electric bicycle. What kind of things you expect in the electric bicycle is basically the need analysis. I'm not asking whether you need an electric bicycle or you need a modern mobile phone. I'm not like asking like that. I'm not asking whether you need to have a better washing machine. So that is not need analysis. That is more of customer's vision for the product. So you are not working on the customer's vision for the product. You are working on your own vision for the product and then trying to see whether that vision has an opportunity or not. Yeah, so probably there is a misunderstanding. Customer need analysis, basically we are doing in order to find out what should be there in that product so that customer will buy it. Okay. No. See, market is basically, is there a market for an electric bicycle or not? That is the market analysis we are doing. Okay, how many people are using cycles? How many people will be interested in buying an electric bicycle? But your own estimate only. And then what will be the approximate cost of a bicycle and which you can sell? Is there a way to make a profit out of that? So we are focusing on that particular segment of the market. And then we decided to make an electric bicycle. Now we need to find out what are the things needed in the electric bicycle. Okay, we are only focusing on that electric bicycle product and whether they like to have it as a combination of both pedaling and electric or only electric. And if it is electric, what should be the duration of charging or what kind of charging to be there, what kind of battery to be in, and what would be the approximate cost they are expecting. So these are the basically customer needs of that product. Okay, not for multiple products we are trying to find out. So this need analysis basically to ensure that whatever you develop will be sold in the market, because it actually meets the expectations of the customer. Got it? Yeah. So that is the customer need analysis for the existing or the product you wish to bring it in the market. You need to understand what kind of expectations are there for the customer in this particular product. And finally, we do a competitive analysis. Analyze the competitive products in the market and then see whether you can really compete with the other manufacturers in the market. If at all there is a competitor. If there is no competitor, of course, you don't need to do directly, but you need to do, an analysis to check whether someone can actually come into the market and then start a new product like this. Is there a potential competitor coming up in the future, or how easy or difficult it is for a competitor to come to the market? That is the competitive analysis. Analyze the competitive products on the market and how will they satisfy the customer needs. So if there is an existing product, you can find out whether this is actually meeting the customer requirements or not. If it is not meeting the customer requirements, what are the issues? And how you can address those things. So that is basically the competitive analysis of the product. So if you do all this analysis, and at the end of this gate, so you have stages and gates, and you cross this gate, then you are saying that yes, there is a good opportunity to design a new product. So that is the first stage of product development, understanding the opportunity. So you need to have a good vision for a product. You should be able to analyze the market opportunity analysis to say that, okay, you will be able to make the product and sell it with a reasonable profit. And once you are sure of that, you look at the customer's need and then see whether you will be able to meet the customer's need or not. And then finally, you look at the competition in the market, how many people will be competing with you, or how can you compete with the existing people and still make profits. So these are the steps you need to go through, or the stages you need to go through to come to the next stage of developing a concept vision. Okay, I'll be discussing about it separately. There are two ways to look at the product design. One is that customer does not know what we are capable of. I will make a product and sell in the market. Okay. The other one is customer is asking for something. Let me satisfy that one. Okay. These are the two ways in which you can do. But in whatever the issue is, whatever may be the method, it is always good to know what the customer is looking for. See, for example, you know, iPod, right? iPods, or okay, you can say iPad also. See, customers were not asking for an iPad or iPod, right? They never say that, okay, I am looking for an iPod or there is something. But the company, they thought that there is a opportunity for that. That is their vision. So they had a vision of developing a product which will actually change the way people listen to music or people use the computers. So that was the vision of the company. Then they did not simply make it and then started selling in the market. So they have gone through the market opportunity. They tried to find out, is there a reasonable profit that you can make? But then it is, they also go through a customer need analysis. Basically, they know what they are going to make, right? So they will try to find out what will be the approximate requirement of the customer. So these customers will be a select group of people who can actually be told about the product, what they are trying to bring it, and what is their requirement. If something comes up in the market like that, whether you will be able to buy it, or whether you will be what kind of things you want this in, want to be available in that product. So that kind of a market survey they do, customer need analysis. The reason is that they don't want to make the product and then later on realize that, oh, we missed that one because people were actually looking for this. We did not get it, or we could not provide that. So to avoid that, they will always do a customer need analysis. Okay. So if you look at the any product, now you can see there are many products which fail in the market, mainly because they could not capture the customer needs properly. Okay. And sometimes because of technology changes and many other things, it will happen. But mainly when the customer need is not properly understood, then the product may fail in the market. There are a lot of examples for products failing because of no focus on customer's needs. So there are methods to analyze the customer needs. We'll go through some simple exercises later to how to analyze the customer's need and then try to convert that into product requirements. Okay, so that is the first step, stage, understand the opportunity. Okay, so at the end of these four activities, the design team understands the state of the competitive market, the customer population, and any available technologies. A gate evaluation can be done. So gate evaluation will be done at the end of this to decide whether to proceed in the development of new concepts. So that is the outcome of this. Understand the opportunity, you will have a gate analysis, and the team and with the management, higher management team will analyze all these findings and then decide whether to go for it or not. And they find that market is not there, they may stop it also. Okay. All of you know about nano car, right? Okay. Was it a success or a failure? Failure. Success. How many are saying success? Okay, there are many people who say it's success. Okay. And many say that it's failure, right? Okay, so tell me, why do you think it is success? What is the reason? It was cheap, cheap, affordable, popular. Yeah, that is the what actually you call it a success, right? Yeah. Somebody said failure, no? Yeah. What do I, why was it failed? Okay. So he says it failed because its design was not good and advertisement was not proper. It was not affordable, right? Okay. So see, affordability was one customer need. They thought that it would be a better thing. And probably they did a customer need analysis to find out what would be the approximate cost of the car that can be, that is considered to be affordable, right? So they put it as 1 lakh in the beginning. I think now it is 2.5 or something like that. But see, one way in terms of innovation, that was a good product. Okay, because nobody in the automobile industry ever thought that you can have a car with for $1,500, right? I mean, in terms of US dollars. So nobody thought that, and they actually went through a lot of design process which actually made it possible. They redesigned almost all the components of the car to make it cheaper, affordable, because all the Indian designers, Indian companies, they reworked their designs to get the product at an affordable price. So in terms of innovation, it was a good product. In terms of cost, it was good. I think in terms of performance also, it was a good car, no doubt about it. I mean, people could actually accept that it's a good in terms of power and all. Okay, there are, of course, the sound was a bit arrogant. I mean, not that comfortable. But why it failed, any idea? Safety, okay. So safety was one concern, yeah. Not profitable, yes. Pardon? They could not compete with other car. There was no other car in the same segment, actually. Yeah. But see, very, very strange reason probably you can find that failure of that car. So when they advertised the car, the advertisement was poor man's car, right? That was what they advertised, poor man's car. How many people would like to called as poor? See, nobody says that I am poor unless to get some money from government. Otherwise, everybody will say, I am not poor. Okay, I have money, I have things. Why should I be called as a poor man? So when you drive a nano, others will think that you are a poor man, right? So nobody wants to get that tag of a poor man. That actually adversely affected the markets. Many people thought that, oh, that is poor man's car, it's not for me. And nobody really wanted to tagged as a poor man, whether they have money or not. Independently, I mean, if you ask anybody, they will say, I am not poor that way. Okay, I am also rich like you. Okay, because it's a very relative term, poor and rich, right? So one of the reasons why it actually could not capture the market, though it has got all the performance and everything, probably they tagged it as a poor man's car, and then people did not really wanted to be tagged as a poor man. Maybe that might be one of the reasons why people did not go for that car. Okay, so that was just to tell you that many things will affect the success of a product. Okay, the second stage in the product development, develop a concept. So once you are sure about there is a opportunity to design to make a new product, then you start developing the concept. Okay, so you have the customer's requirement already understood. So you need to see what the product must do to supply the customer satisfaction. So the supplier, the customer satisfaction through customer need analysis, you try to find out what are the requirements of the customer. And once you understood the requirements of the customer, it is the job of the designer to see how to satisfy the customer. This is where the creativity of the designer comes into picture. Because customer will tell, oh, it should look nice. Okay, it should be affordable. And I should feel proud of using this product. So this kind of very subjective customer needs will be mentioned. It is the job of the designer to see how can we convert these subjective requirements of the customer to objective design needs and then put that into the product. When the customer says it should look nice, what you will do as a designer? It's only the outer part you want to make it very attractive, or the customer says should be very comfortable to use. What do you mean by comfortable? Because that comfort basically depends on various factors, right? So the designer need to check what the product must do to meet the customer's expectations or meet the satisfaction of the customer. And this can actually be done through something called the functional modeling of the products. We need to see what kind of functions to be there in the product to meet the customer satisfaction. Customer says it should be comfortable to use. It is the job of the designer to see what functions will make the customer this comfortable. What are the functions that can be in the product to make the product comfortable to use for the customer? So this is a challenge, because customer won't be telling you what you should do in the product. They will say it should be comfortable. Yeah. And the cycle, when you ask the cycle user, he will say I should use less effort. Simply he will say the effort to drive the cycle should be very less, or it should be almost zero effort. Now it is the designer to find out how to make the effort zero, or how to make the effort very less. And that is where you try to identify the functions in the product which will make the effort zero. So this is basically known as functional modeling of a product. So under the functional and conceptual design, so we'll be going to the functional modeling later. Once you do the opportunity analysis, then we'll look into the functional modeling. And then we look at the architecture of the product. That is, there will be multiple components in the product. How do you actually bring them together? You have electronics, you have electrical parts, you have mechanical parts, you have displays, or you have some other safety features. How do we arrange them properly in order to get the product suitable for the customer? That is basically known as product architecture development. So the functional model and alternative product architectures set the stage for effective concept engineering. Okay, so that is the conceptual development of the product. And sometimes you develop many concepts to implement the functional specification, and later on you choose the best concept to take to the next level of implementing the concept. So you look at the customer needs, develop the functional models, and then look at the architecture, and based on this develop lot of concepts for the new products. And out of these many concepts, you take the best concept out of it and then develop it as a prototype development, testing, and then taking it to the market. So that is the concept engineering. So that's the second stage. First was understand the opportunity. The second was develop a concept. And the last one is basically implementing a concept. So this part is more of CAD modeling, stress analysis, and make sure that all this meets the requirements, and then making a prototype, testing, all those things. So we will not be discussing this in detail in this course, but just to tell you, that is the third stage which you will be learning later as separate topics in design of mechanical system, design of electronic systems, etc. You will be understanding these things. So that is basically the three stages of product development understand the opportunity, develop a concept, and implement a concept. So to summarize, so this is these are the three stages activities in a typical product development process. You have understand the opportunity, and there you have develop a vision, market opportunity, customer need analysis, and competitive analysis. These four will be the part of understand the opportunity. Then you have develop a concept. Okay, these are the different things you will be doing: portfolio, functional modeling, architecture, concept engineering. So we'll be discussing these in detail in the classes. Classes coming up in the next week. Most of these will be discussed in the next 2 months, and this one we will not be discussing in this course. That will be done later.